Hi guys.
Hi.
Hi.
What guys are you? What grade are you? Freshman.
You know we're.
You want to be saying like what are we doing? I'm a sophomore, and once you pass law or you go to law next year and you stay in the magnet program, you would have what's called leadership management. So what that does, it helps you build up skills of like talking in front of a class right now with a bunch of people like freshmen like you guys. And what we're doing is it's a project called the Transformation Project. So we're trying to create awareness about domestic violence. And I'm gonna give the stage to my partner.
Hi, how are you guys doing? My name is Anthony Ramirez, and here's my partner, Manuel Cabrera. So as I said, we're gonna do a Transformation Project based on domestic violence. We're gonna raise awareness. So we believe that's where the place to start is the freshmen, because you guys are the future. Like, we're all the future. So let's get talked younger. See your kids, you know, give them an idea of what you guys already should know. So we'll go on to the next slide, please.
Say no to domestic violence. American troops kill about 6,488 Afghanistan soldiers and Iraqis. From 2001 to 2012, women who are murdered by current or ex-male partners during time is 11,766. So it's double of the double of American troops. So if you multiply it by two, that almost equals 11,766. There will be 85% of domestic violence victims are women, and 324,000 women experience violence during the pregnancy. And every 9 seconds in the U.S., a woman is assaulted or beaten. 1 in 4 victims will experience domestic violence in a lifetime, and 3 million children witness domestic violence in their homes every year.
So do you guys believe that domestic violence just happens with in a relationship, so just a guy and a girl? Do you guys just believe that it only affects those two people?
No.
Who do you think that it affects as well? So,
sorry.
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 So we can go to the next slide. Thank you. So it doesn't only affect the mother and father, it also affects the children. Because children, as you two are fighting, as two couples are fighting, basically the children are fighting here, they're just material, you know? And basically it's hard for the children deal with this, because basically you're just here, you have a brother and sister, you're just trying to take care of each other, just telling each other it's okay. So we go to this next slide, please. So some warning signs.
Okay, some warning signs. So we might print out papers, like you might see them in the hallways or in the cafeteria or posted, and these are warning signs. Like if you see someone who is being a victim, you see you would see victims are sudden changes in their appearance, like you see bruises, or they're emotionally hurt, or you, if they're a friend and you are a best friend with them, you might see them act differently. And what you do is decide what to tell someone or an adult, a counselor about this, and please, like, just, they might, the number one factor is fear, so they'll partner will use fear to oppress someone so they don't talk. So if, for example, if I oppress, say I have a girlfriend and I tell her, if you tell someone I'm going to beat you, you can come home or you're going to beat you out to school. That's what they do. That's why they change so much in their emotion or their appearance. You might go into the next slide, please.
Alright, so we have a scenario. So this is just for the girl. So it's a guy was getting you mad. Did you end up to the point where you just want to hit him and smack him across the face a couple times, you know? Stop
yes.
Now a couple times. Would you guys do it?
Yes.
Yes? So those of you that said yes, why?
Why not?
Why not?
Why?
Why?
Like they're making you mad.
No.
So what if I was to alright, so let's go. Let's say not trying to say get in a relationship, but let's say you guys are in a relationship. You know, you guys get growing up and all. You got a boyfriend. She's hanging out with another guy, would you end up getting them?
What?
So let's say if you guys are in a relationship and a guy gets mad hanging out with other girls, would you get to the point where you just smack him in the head?
No, I'm going to let my dad
no.
Take care of him.
Or threaten him, or threaten him with other things. No?
She's so excited.
Right. So for the guys, if a girl ever got you mad, let's say she smacked you, would you hit her back?
No.
Then
I get your sister. They all slept together. All right. So we're going minute at a time. So let's say, so those of you who say yes or think yes or maybe, you never know, it can happen. Just a reaction and just swing back, right? Either way, abuse is wrong for either gender. It's not just guys hitting girls. Also, it's also girls hitting guys. It also affects a guy, whether you guys believe it or not. You guys could affect a guy emotionally. There was a guy that we know, a teacher that told us a story. This guy affected, he was in a marriage for years, and he faced emotional abuse. And basically, he did not want to leave that abuse because everything that she made him feel made him feel bad, and she just ended up feeling like he was to blame for. So it's not just physical abuse that people face, it's also emotional abuse because you just end up feeling bad. So I'm gonna tell you guys a story. So there is this kid that used to live in Mexico. He was in the back of a truck with his brother. So they want to go buy some hot dogs and all. So they're eating in the back of the truck, you know, in the pickup truck. Just, it's the funnest thing in your life when you get in the back. So this kid, he saw inside his truck, it was tinted windows. And all he saw was like a lot of screaming. Their parents screaming. Probably he doesn't know if the guy's like grabbing the girl's hair and just like smacking her on the dashboard and all. He doesn't know, so he just gets a sick feeling. Have you guys ever had that sick feeling when you guys feel like something's wrong?
Yeah.
So this little kid had this little sick feeling, and he's like, man, I'm not hungry, so he just threw his whole hot dog away because he wasn't that hungry. And basically, all you hear is screaming and screaming, like, they're arguing a lot. So this truck stops in front of his grandma's house, right? And all you see is his father walk out to the passenger door and open the door and jump in right in the truck and starts hitting the mother. So this brother, he was the oldest one, right there with the little younger brother. And he jumps off the truck, but all he does is just stare into his speech. But he has his little brother jump off, and he just, his little brother is the one that took action, saying, hey, like, dad, stop, stop, like screaming at him, and his dad stopped. So how do you guys think that the older brother felt? He's the older one, right? So you guys think that he should have took action? So his younger brother took action. So this kid had always had nightmares ever since, and he felt useless because basically he didn't do anything for his family. He saw his mom get beat, and his little brother had to take action. And it was hard for him. So just to let you guys know, that person was me, and it's really, abuse is wrong. So say no to abuse. If you guys want to wear purple on Fridays, come join us.
Wear purple on Fridays?
Yes.